Hi guys, welcome to Momo Tutorials. We are continuing with our vectors. Today we are looking at the magnitude of vectors, okay? So we are saying magnitude simply means that you are calculating the length. So for example, if they ask you the magnitude of AB, they are simply asking for the length of AB. And when they are asking for magnitude, they have a special way of saying it. They will not ask it as magnitude. They can just put these two kind of brackets. You can see they are brackets. Okay, so they'll just write your AB like that, and then they put something like that. That's to show you that they are asking for magnitude. So whenever they ask you for magnitude, I need to take note of something. It simply means that you must calculate length. Length. And how do we calculate length? So we are simply going to, let's have a look. Let's say we are given vector A, which is xy. Remember, the top value is the x value, the bottom value is the y value. So when they ask the magnitude of our vector A now, how are we going to calculate it? We say it is the square root of x squared plus y squared. Square root of x squared plus y squared. So now, let's apply this to AB and CD. Okay, we said that when a given vector A, which is xy, the magnitude of that vector, which is the length of that vector, you simply say x squared plus y squared. So now, coming back to this one, AB, they told us it's 3, 4. Now, let's calculate its magnitude. So magnitude of AB, so like I said, when they're asking you for magnitude, they're just going to put those two lines, okay? So the magnitude of AB will say is the square root of 3 squared plus 4 squared. What is 3 squared? It's 9. 4 squared, it's 16. What is 9 plus 16? It's a 25. So this gives us square root of 25. We know the square root of 25 is a 5, right? We'll take the positive 5. We cannot have a negative length, right? That's for the modulus of AB, which is what? The length of AB, the magnitude of AB. What about CD? They gave us CD and they said it's minus 4, 3. Take note of something. So our CD, the magnitude of CD, we are going to say is the square root of our x squared, so it's minus 4 squared plus 3 squared. Minus 4 squared, it's a 16. Most people, they get it wrong here. Plus 9, which is exactly the same. 16 plus 9, we're getting a 25, and our magnitude is 5. Take note of this. Minus 4 to the power 2, it's a positive 16. It's not a negative 16. Otherwise, at the end of the day, you end up with an error there. Minus 16 plus 9, square root of a negative does not exist. Okay, so take note of that. A negative, once you square it, it becomes positive. So minus 4 to the power 2 will get a positive 16, okay? That was for our first examples. Let's have a look at our second example. They started off by, I'm going to clear up, to create space. They gave us vector P, and vector P is minus 5, 2. Vector P, minus 5, 2, vector Q, minus 7, 3. And first part of the question, they said find P minus Q. Second part of the question, they said find P plus Q. Third part of the question, they said find Q minus P. The fourth part, they want you to find P plus Q. The fifth part, it's P, magnitude of P plus Q. The fifth part, they want us to find the magnitude of P minus Q. All right, this is exciting. So now let's first subtract P minus Q. I hope you guys still remember how to subtract column vectors, okay? So P, it's minus 5, 2, okay? And then minus Q, which is a minus 7, 3. So minus 5 minus minus 7. Minus and a minus is a plus. So we now have minus 5 plus 7, here 2 minus 3, okay? Minus 5 plus 7 is a positive 2. 2 minus 3 is a negative 1. So this is our A, which is P minus Q. Okay? Then B, P plus Q. So it's minus 5, 2 plus minus 7, 3. Minus 5 plus minus 7, it becomes minus 5 minus 7. Because a plus and a minus, when they follow each other like that, they will give us a negative, okay? 2 plus, and then we have a 2 plus 3. So this is going to be minus 12. 2 plus 3 is a 5. So it's minus 12, 5, and a 2 negative 1, okay? That's our A and B. So for now, let's keep them like that. P minus Q, we got a 2 minus 1. P plus Q, we got a minus 12, 5. We are going to use P plus Q on our D day, right? So that's why I'm saying we must keep it like that. So let's keep in mind that for P plus Q, we got minus 12, 5. Let me write it here, minus 12, 5. Okay. And then for Q minus P, okay, they're not the same. So now, give me, let me erase so that we can do C, D, E. So I'm going to clean up this one. I kept my P plus Q. All right, that's perfect. Let's do our Q minus, our C is Q minus P. Q, it's minus 7, 3. P, it's minus 5, 2. So we have minus 7. A minus will become a plus. Minus 7 plus 5. And a 3 minus 2. Minus 7 plus 5, we have a minus 2. 3 minus 2, it's a minus 1. So minus 2 minus 1. We are keeping our Q minus P. And then for D, they want the modulus of P plus Q. What did we get for P plus Q? Minus 12, 5 was our solution for P plus Q. So now modulus of P plus Q, the magnitude of P plus Q. So we're simply going to say it's the square root of minus 12 squared plus 5 squared. I know 12 squared is 144 plus 5 squared is a 25, okay? And then what's 144 plus 25? That's going to be 5, not a 5. 4 plus 5, it's a 9. And then 4 plus 2, it's a 6. And then that's now the square root of 169. What is the square root of 169? Let me confirm if it's a 13. Let me confirm it with my calculator. Square root of 169. Root 169. Yes, it's a 13. So square root of 169, it's a 13. So that's the size of P plus Q. Okay, what about P minus Q? The magnitude of P minus Q. P minus Q, we calculated P minus Q and we got 2, 1. Okay, we got 2, 1. This is Q minus P. So Q minus P is like the negation of P minus Q. So our P minus Q, we got a positive 2, 1. So let's take it from there. We had 2, 1. Let me just confirm it. Minus 5, 2, minus 7, 3. So this then becomes minus 5 plus 7. And 2 minus 1 gives 2 minus 3. So this becomes 2 minus 1, okay? It's 2 minus 1, all right. 2 minus 1. So the magnitude for this one is going to be the square root of 2 squared plus minus 1 squared. 2 squared is a 4. 4 plus 1 is a 5. So our magnitude for this one, we'll leave it as root 5, okay? Since we don't know the exact square root of root 5. So that's it on magnitude of a vector. So what I want you to take from this whole lesson is that when you see your vector and they're putting two lines like that on your vector, it simply means you must calculate your the magnitude. And what is magnitude? It's the length of that particular vector. And how do we calculate length? You see, you're simply going to square the x value and the y value, and then you add them together under a square root sign, right? So simply the square root of your x squared plus y squared, okay? So after doing that, you always take the positive answer. You don't take a negative answer. We all know the square root of 25 is a 5, but you're not going to say your answer is plus or minus 5. Your answer will be a positive 5 because we are talking of length. We cannot have a negative length. Okay, so that's all for today. See you on our next lesson.